Woohoo!
Into the bridge of the music. Here we go. Good morning, gang. Yeah. J-Rock, the clapping comment. I totally missed that one. I completely blew the clapping intro there. Yeah. My goodness. That's why I'm not a professional hand clapper. Oh, boy. Hey, gang, how's everybody doing today?
It's another Wednesday.
Good morning.
It is indeed. And hello to everybody in the chat. Hope everybody's caught up on the weather. There we go. Gang, we have Kevin Thorn back with us today. Those of you who have joined us in the past have perhaps met Kevin. We bring Kevin in for all things artistic. He's our guide to the drawing. Back to the drawing board. That's what we should call the whole thing with Kevin.
Back to the drawing board.
Yeah, yeah. On the other hand, there are maybe some folks who are new to our session here today. Don't know you yet, Kevin. So let's give you a chance to introduce yourself. Tell us all a little bit about you.
Okay. What do you want to know? No, just kidding.
Yeah.
All the things.
I'm celebrating my retirement. As of, golly, it's been 22 years since I left that career. So then I went, most of you know this story, but after the Army, I went down the informational technology path. I was going to be the one to fix the next Y2K problem. Mm-hmm. That lasted about 3 years. And then I was invited to the training department and, hey, we've got this really cool idea. We want to take all of our three-ring binder training and make it a website and be able to know who accessed the website. Nice. I think they call it a learning management system. Go make that happen. I had no idea what I was doing, but for the next decade, I guess that's where we just kind of dove in and kind of self-taught myself the industry in terms of more on the technology side, how to get everything working. SCORM, went to SCORM school actually a week down in Florida and actually learned how to handwrite an IMS manifest file. And that was kind of murder.
Now you're saying handwrite. Was that like in
hand code?
In cursive or was that printed?
On a legit notepad.
Hand code. And then shortly after that, it was some e-learning tool vendor came up with this fascinating idea that there's a button. All you got to do is click the button and they'll write all the code for you. I was like, well, that was a week I'll never get back. I still have the four SCORM volumes around here somewhere.
Nice.
Anyway, did that for a little while. And then, it was right about the time Brent and I met, 2010, 2009, somewhere around that area. iPad had just come out and, mobile technology was kind of the thing at the time. And there was a lot of cool things that we were doing and I couldn't get corporate to move fast enough. And, corporate's corporate, right? Budgets, fiscal years, all that kind of stuff. But it was frustrating because technology was moving at such a pace at that time that if you didn't move, you were going to, if you had to wait for the fiscal year budget to catch up, technology, it's like so yesterday by the time you get to do something. Right. So I started freelancing just to basically, I was curious. So I started freelancing to see what we could do. And then started my own company in 2012. And that was 9 years ago next week. Cool. And the rest is history. And then I went back, got my master's in 2018. Figuring I was inadequate, there's something I was missing. So I went back to school thinking I should probably learn some stuff that I don't know, which was helpful because I did learn some things that I didn't know. And now I'm in a doctoral program. So my goal now is to throw a few extra letters after my name by the time I'm age 60. We'll see how that happens. We'll see how that goes. That's all
Gotta
you know.
Have the letters. Gotta have
Very
the letters.
Cool.
Well, the goal is... Army for one career, training and development for another career, and then I'll be a curmudgeon old professor at some community college the rest of my life.
Get those elbow patches going.
That's right. Yeah, the tweed jacket.
Exactly. We all aspire. Yeah. There we go.
Someday.
Sandals, tweed jacket and sandals.
There we go. Nice combo.
The only thing you'll be missing is that you won't be able to have chalk all over your hands from the chalk.
Still could do that. That's still an option.
No, I could totally do that. And then if you get in trouble, go clean the erasers.
There we go.
Go outside and slap the erasers on the side of the wall. Don't come in until they're clean.
No kidding.
We're talking about characters and shapes and putting people in positions and building our own characters, because Lord knows we all need them in our fancy e-learning courses, right?
Right.
Yeah, so in the past, you've walked us through all kinds of different visual things, the visual alphabet, and then took us, you know, steps further in teaching us how to draw some characters. And we did that, we did that just before Christmas, didn't we? We all worked on our snowman.
That's right.
So we all got very proficient at that. Let's jump into what we're going to talk about today.
Yeah, so, as you know, that's kind of where my world is. I mean, obviously, I'm an instructional designer, e-learning developer, but I teach visual literacy and how do we communicate things through, you know, the universal language of visual metaphors and visual language. Today, we're not going to get so much into that. Where we're going to get into, when we're building e-learning and you go on that hunt for that particular character or that, you know, that idea, and we're not going to get into themes and styles and all that today. We're just going to look at a tool that if you can't find that right pose, there's a tool now that you can create your own custom poses, export those images out into your favorite drawing tool, Photoshop. I'm going to use Procreate today. And then just basically trace over it, then you create your style, colors, things like that. And it's a pretty slick app, and it's $20, which I think is quite reasonable considering the cost of software today. Want to get started? I guess we just share my screen and get started.
Yeah, let's rock into it.
Okay. Make sure all my buttons are in the right place.
Now, this is an actual download of an app, right? It's not, is it a browser-based app?
Well, it's a browser-based app. You can access the app on, hang on, let me make sure I hit the right button here.
Put it on my other screen.
There we go.
I thought for sure I bought it, but now I can't find a license key. So I'm
there. We go. And I put the app. I put the URL in the chat early on when we started this morning. Let me put it back in there again. So there it is. galshear.com/pose. So it's $20, $19. And you can kind of go through here and see this particular examples are, as you can see, it's an Apple Pencil. So they're using probably Procreate or some drawing tool on the iPad. I've tried doing this on the iPad, actually using the app on the iPad, but it has kind of a funky way of downloading. You can't really download the art very well. And I'll show you an example of that when we get over. So my method right now is... my method right now is using the web browser, export it, and then drop it in, save your image somewhere, and then import that into your app. So once you get the app, you open the app, and now it's a browser-based app. So this is what it looks like. And if we take this character, I can move this character, just drag it around. We simply have the walk cycle right here. On the left is a scale. I don't know how the streaming is going to work here, so I'll go slow.
It's so we can scale good, actually.
It. Okay. And then we've got some, different settings here. I'm going to come all the way to the bottom first to kind of give you, there's 30 presets. So if you wanted a default character, you wanted a walking character, here's sort of a Superman style. And there's all kinds of default poses. It was kind of one. There was walking a dog or standing with a dog. Of course, dog not included here with the pose. They've got this posing, like kind of
Vogue. Yoga poses.
Oh my.
Yeah. Yoga poses. You know, here's pushing a wall. So let's go back up here and let's just kind of start with this like walking one. So once you kind of, you start with a pose that might be, you know, let's not get into instructional design. So you've got your project, you're thinking of, I need a character, I need this pose or whatever. And then once you have it, this is the fun part, right? You can take, come on, play with, stay with me. Here we go. So now you can start, you know, fine tuning what you want to do with the pose. Like so. And then your hand, when you click on the hand, you've got different types of hands. So if I wanted to do like that and then maybe flip it around. And then the little dot, this is how you turn it. So you see, it's, you can go down a rabbit hole real fast here playing around with, you know, what's a good, and then same with your legs. You just grab the leg, do a little kick off the back. We're running fast here. We got this.
The long jumper.
Yeah, there you go. That, and we got this. Trying to get this one here. Let's see.
The casual long jumper.
That back, I can't get that back arm. There we go. I need to get that back arm like that, and maybe something like this. Yeah,
you should be able to rotate the body slightly, right?
Yeah. Yeah. So once you get your pose, I don't know. So let's say we're playing with that right there. Then you've got these character things here. So if you want to squat your, you know, maybe more of a childlike size.
Love it.
Right? Stretch it out a little bit. And then your body shape. So remember, this is just the core. All you're doing is the core. And then this is the angle. So this is where you can rotate it. So if you want to get some perspective, right? So let's see. I can turn my head this way. I mean, there's hours and hours of fun, right? So you can get lost in here pretty good. So that's your background. You can import an image if you want to. I've tried this one time and it's kind of useless, because if you're going to be exporting the pose into another tool, then you put your backgrounds and stuff in there. So it's really not necessary to do it here, because it locks your, you might want to adjust your character and move it around a background. If you put it in this, it's locked right onto that background. So it doesn't,
it's not like a layered thing where you can then, when you export it, it separates it again.
Okay. Right. If you need a grid, fill shapes. So if you want to fill and kind of get more of a structure of what it might look like. So there's quite a few tools right here to kind of help you get going.
Can you move what the I've done, fingers at all? Or is it just you have to
No, it's just different hands.
Okay.
So let's see if we can zoom in here a little bit. Hang on. There we go. So once you click on, then you've got this library of hands, you know, and then flip them. So however you want to do your hand. Woohoo. What's that music we were listening to this morning? Right. And then there we go. Ooh. And this could be, you know, right now, the first thing that comes to mind is like, a streaker going across the football field at Super Bowl. Woo-hoo! Mm. Right. So you kind of have an idea of the type of character you're looking for. Obviously, you don't want to put that in your e-learning course, but you get the idea, right? So
that sounds like that's an annual compliance. You have the checkbox. You will not streak at the Super Bowl. Check.
Right.
Agree.
But like I said, there's all these different default poses, and the fill shape. So if I turn that back off, it just depends, I guess, on, you know, what kind of browser you're using. And you see the lighter colors in the background. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you can see, it's kind of it's a little bit lighter color. That kind of gives you the idea that that's, you know, on the backside, you know, looking at the profile. The fill shapes really help out, because it really, you know, there's a higher contrast here. Right. So then when I rotate the body, that's not a really good one to rotate. Let's try this one.
Stop.
Here's one. It's walking the dog.
I should have prepped this a little bit better and had some musical sound effects to play along with some of these.
Right. It feels like each of these has a character.
Well, let's jump over to iPad and show. So I've exported all 30 of these just to kind of give you an idea what's going on. So let's jump over.
Here's while you're switching between those apps, I'll use this as an opportunity to just remind folks that there are other reasons why you would want to do this kind of thing, right? With trying to come up with and find the perfect inclusive character, right, is often very difficult. Mm-hmm. Like you might find the right pose, but it's a picture of the wrong gender or the wrong ethnicity that you're looking for. And so,
right. That gets into the artistic side of it, right? This is just a frame. Some of you may know, think of the old, I don't know if my camera's still out, but you know, these little guys here, right?
Right.
These little wooden characters.
Yeah,
so
the
I've got
a digital version of the shape doll.
Yeah. So it's doll. It's the same thing, you know, old school drawing school, you would put this on your desk and you would make the pose, and the little springs on this one are all worn out, but, and then you would just freehand draw or take a picture of it, take a photo of it, bring the photo into a digital app. So it's still the same thing. You're just getting a pose, expressions, clothing, cultural appropriate clothing, depending on that's all style. And that just comes down to, what you can do from an artistic side of things. But if you wanted to do silhouettes, you just wanted characters to, solid colors, just to demonstrate that there's a character in this scene and it might have a speaking role with a speech bubble or something like that. You don't really need to get into all the details. But it's totally up to you. It's just a framework to help you get your poses in place. And then what you do with it after that is totally up to you. Here's the same app in the app. Let me back up, because I wanted to show you, hang on. Kathy had mentioned, what kind of formats, or Katie, sorry, formats is export to. Your export button down here at the bottom, it's just download the image, and it is a PNG format.
I was going to say probably a PNG, okay. So you get the transparency.
So that's right? The only option you get, PNG. So if you wanted to convert this to an SVG or a vector file or something like that, you'd have to do it externally. The problem with this app version of the same thing, I'm in a browser, I'm in the same Chrome browser, but on the iPad Pro, if I do export here, I'm trying to use my mouse on the screen. It don't work that way.
It's like me reaching out to touch my monitor. I'm like, oh yeah, that's right.
Yeah, right. what this does is, you can't even tell, it's not there. Yeah, so it's just a screenshot of the image instead of actually downloading it. So the export feature using the browser-based app on a tablet only exports to a screenshot. It doesn't actually export a file. So that's one of the things, maybe they'll update it at some point later. We'll see. But for here, let's go ahead and I'm in Procreate. It's going to grab a new screen. We'll add a file. And then I've got all, these are the 30. Let's do the Superman pose. Import, and there's our Superman. So now this is just an image file. And again, this is just, I'm just going to show you some techniques inside what I do inside Procreate. So the first thing I'm going to do, it loads it up as a layer. I'm going to give it opacity, kind of gray it out a little bit so I can see it. So when I draw on top of it, it's not the same thickness of the black line. And then pick a brush. I'll just do an ink bleed. One of the things, another technique, is I don't want to draw on the same layer. because this is going to go away. So I'm going to add another layer on top of it, and I'll draw on this layer. And then now it's just tracing, you know, now it's just what type of style. So remember, this is, let me kind of do some fundamentals here, right? So here's the baseline right here down the center. So if you just wanted to do a stick figure, you know what I mean? You don't have to have drawing skills, right?
Right.
So you could come down here and do a stick figure like this. Just draw the center. Just draw right down the center line.
And then you get, then you've got the proportions right and everything because you've got that right to go with. The onion skinning, yes, Molly, thank you.
Right. So once you have that word, you turn off the background, and you essentially have a relatively useful stick figure that you could use. Right.
Yep.
So let's take it to another level here. Let's kind of give it a shape. So remember, this doesn't show up as much. Remember the fills. See how this would be the back. I'm pointing with my pencil as if you know what I'm looking at. I'm sorry. So this is the arm and behind the body, and this is the forearm foreground, right? So background foreground. So knowing that this is the foreground, we're going to take this and I'm going to do kind of the rubber, you know, just some fun shape like that. And this is where you play. You don't have to follow those dotted lines, but if you're new to this type of style, follow those dotted lines until you get sort of that habit. And so you start feeling what you're trying to feel. And I'm just going to just make some really loose kind of curvy lines here. Like this. Here.
I really like this because in all of the other like sort of freehand sketching practice work that we've done with you on these idiotic episodes, my proportions have always been just off enough to make it look goofy and not as good as yours. and so when we were talking about this and I saw this, I thought, oh, it's that this will help me with those proportions. Because you're right. You don't have to draw exactly those lines. You can just use it as a guide to say, okay, this is where you want
the
body.
That's all it is.
No matter what type of body you're going to put on this shape or this character, you can you at least know where everything is and the approximate, you know, all the sizing and everything is going to look right.
It's a guide
than we really are.
No, it's a guide. Just keep in remember, it's a guide, and this is not about what particular artistic style skill you may or may not have, but it's a tool to help you get better at being that, right? So there's, you don't have to be artistic. You just kind of think differently. Here's the frame. Here's the guide. Stay within these dotted lines and you'll come up with a decent character proportionately accurate, right? You don't have to stay within those dotted lines. You could go outside the lines. Jonathan, it's been a while since I used spine. I forgot about that tool. It's been a while. It used to be an animation tool, or it still is, I guess.
Sounds a little bit more advanced, though. Probably got a.
Well, the onion skinning, and we're gonna do a little example of onion skinning here in a minute. Molly had just mentioned it, so let's go the other right. Let's plump this character up again. We're not really staying inside these lines, so let's do something a little plumpier. So just, and again, it's all about, this is our snowman again, right? Or marshmallow man or whatever you want to call him. Like this, just kind of exaggerate now. And this is where you start learning. When you do it like this, you're like, oh my gosh, that's a completely different character than the other one I just drew.
Mm-hmm.
And you're using the same guidelines. Da da da. Da 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 da. There we go. So if I were to take both of these, let's see, move them side by side, using the same guide, two different characters. And I'm doing this quick, right? So just for demonstration,
yep.
Obviously. But now if you want to take it, now if you wanted to, so we've got this layer 2 highlighted. Now, if you want to color that or fill that in, put another layer behind that one underneath layer 2. Now, here's the big secret. Make sure all of your lines are connected. Because when you fill it, there we go. Actually, I don't think I need that. I can go here. Let's give it a color. And then in Procreate, you fill a color and just grab this dot up here in the corner and drag it to the center. Oh no, there's a line open somewhere. And it might be this type of pencil. Hang on just a minute. Let me see if I can close up these gaps.
The back of the neck, maybe.
Oh, yep, right there.
Looking a little.
That's probably what it was right there. Okay, let's try it again.
Phil.
No. Doesn't work. If that doesn't work, you can do this. Just come in here, grab this one. Let's give it a nice thick one. And what's fun about this part is because you're behind it, you can go pretty sloppy up against the line, and it's going to go underneath that black line. So then you just color it in.
Cool.
Whoops, a little outside the lines there, Kevin. Come on. Actually, that's kind of that's not a bad style. Let's kind of play with that. Let's do that. Let's see what that looks like. That's not a bad look.
Messy?
Yeah, kind of a messy. This is Electric Eel Man. He's got this sort of electric aqua glow about him. There we go.
Oh, anyway, there's that wrist where that opening is right there.
Yeah, I see it. Yep, that's where it was. Okay. Anyway, there's an idea, right?
Yep.
Now let's try. How much time we got? Let's make sure we got enough time. Let's go back, start over, get a new one. Now this time we're gonna try some. We're gonna try an animated walk cycle. Now we don't have enough time to do a complete walk cycle, but I'm gonna grab three. I've got three kind of started here. There's one. Then we're gonna do it again. Now I created this. This is the default walking pose. And then the second one, whoops, where am I going here? Well, come on.
Loading.
Well, I'm connected to Crowdcast, so, right? What's going on there now? Well, this is not helpful.
Darn iPad.
There we go. What is there? There's walking two. That's what I want. So in the pose app, you move the arms and the legs a little bit. And you keep doing that for your different stages of the walk cycle. Yeah. And they land right on top. And what's nice about, they're all going to go right in the center, so they're right exactly the same way. Now, again, I did this quick, so, you know, the baseline might be off a little bit. The arms might not quite be where they're supposed to be. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off the top two, take some of this down a little bit. And, again, a layer on top because I don't want to draw on the actual layer. Let me get it here. Let's get a little different pen. And we'll try to stay as close to this dotted line as we can.
Now, I don't want to break your stride, but just
go ahead while I'm doing this.
Understand what you're doing. Are you going to have to draw the outline on each one of those images, or does it do it for you? Okay.
No. You got to do it. This is the busy work, right?
Right. Okay.
So I'm doing it quite fast. I'm not.
Well, you're good.
Mm-hmm. Just trace. At this point, all I'll do is just trace it. You're just tracing.
You know, one little thing that I'm noticing as you're doing this is, you know, you're rotating so that you're always in, I'm going to call it the comfort zone of your pen usage, where my spazzy brain would be trying to do the and I'm looking going, oh, that's so cool. Just rotate it.
No. So all right. So here's a tip, right? Watch this. So I'm going to put a dot here. I'm going to put a dot here, right? I'm going to draw a line left to right. This is A. This is B. Right? Mm-hmm. I'm going to draw a straight line across horizontally. I'm going to push it, right? There's my push line. I'll do the same thing, but I'll pull it going right to left. So this is A, this is B. You're going to practice at home. If I pull it, I still got that line, right? Now, here's the secret sauce. Always pull down towards you because you have the most control.
Righto.
Right? So, and then this, this next tip is reminiscent of the time when I was 6 years old. I got my brand new Schwinn Stingray, and I, within hours of getting my new bike on my birthday, I crashed and I was in the hospital for 4 days with a concussion, which is probably why my head's the way it is today. And I always remember this. When you ride a bike, think about when you're a kid and you're riding a bike. Do you look at the front tire when you're riding a bike, or do you look to where you're going? Because if you look at the front tire, you tend to miss things and you can stumble and crash and things like that, right? So put your pen at the A dot and then put your eye on the B dot, not the three dot, the B dot. Put your eye at the B dot and then pull to where your eye is at. And you get a straighter line.
Mm-hmm. Perfect.
Right? So you're always pulling back towards yourself. And you, over time, you get a straighter line. So always go like this and pull. Right? Turn your paper. And that's why I like this particular app, because some of the other apps don't rotate. You have to rotate the actual iPad and that gets clunky.
Right.
Mm. Okay. Let's keep going.
Yeah. Keep going. Sorry.
No, go ahead.
That's like a 2-finger pinch on the screen then to rotate it on the iPad and the app. Just kind of just go.
You just two fingers and twist.
Yep. Got it.
Nice. Okay.
Twist the can and then pinch and expand, twist like that. So I'm left-handed and then I use my right hand opposite, you know. All right. So we're done with that one. We're going to turn those two off, turn the next one on. Reduce its opacity. So now it's just a rhythm, right? Another letter up. Now we're going to trace this one. And wrong one there. Let's go like this. And again, I'm just kind of going fast for the sake of demonstration. Whoa, that's a little big foot right there. Let's clean that up a little bit. And then this is you got to really know. I probably should have done the fill shapes, but this comes all the way up like this. This, you don't even see this arm till about right there.
Yeah.
Like that. And then we're done with that one. We'll turn those off, turn this one on, give it a little opacity.
So when you imported those images, did you put them on individual layers or did it come?
No, it automatically does that for you. Yeah, it automatically does that for you. Every time you bring in a new image file, Procreate will drop them on its own layer.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Yeah, so it's pretty cool. Now this one, now remember, we've got to think of the walk cycle. Where's the next one? So this is now the foreground.
So the pose tool creates the walk cycle individual images, and then you export those individual images in the positions if you wanted to maneuver them around a little bit more, if you liked the way they created it. Then you export it. It's several different images. Then you import those several images into Procreate or some other type of imaging tool. And in your case, it drops each individual image onto a different layer. Then you go through and you draw each image, and now you still have the walk cycle.
Correct.
And you could turn it into a GIF or whatever.
Right. So exactly. You just walk through the exact steps, right? Now you can, Photoshop does animated GIFs the same way. So it just depends on your pen tablet kind of, and now Photoshop is available on the iPad. So you could do this in there. I haven't tried the animated GIF on the iPad version of Photoshop yet, but I do animated GIFs in Photoshop desktop app all the time. Now that you get your three drawings done, you turn them on, and you know, it might look like a mess, but that's your cycle, right? So let's give it a whirl, see what it looks like. In Procreate, you have the wrench tool, and then the share button. And then all the way down here at the bottom, we've got animated GIF. And it gives you a little preview. And then you can do, it's right now it's at 15 frames per second. We can slow that down, let's say, to 12. That's still kind of it's kind of clunky, so let's cancel that. And let's do animation on twos, which means every two frames. So I'm going to duplicate this frame. I'm going to duplicate this frame. And I'll duplicate this frame. So now that frame, it's two frames, but it'll look like the same frame. So it'll be two on twos. That's the term. So now when we play it, there we go. We got a little strut going on now. Hello, everybody. Let's go. Put a little music behind that fella. We're good to go.
Yeah, there was a Travolta pose reference earlier. And now all I'm hearing is the Saturday Night Fever theme as that guy walks along.
That's right. I'm going to delete these twos for now. Let's play. I'm just going to play something here real quick. Turn this off right here. We go there and let's say, we got a little tree right here.
A happy little tree.
Happy little tree. and then I'm going to copy that tree. And then I'm going to go over here to this layer. I'm going to paste that tree, but now I'm going to move it back over here a little bit. And then I'm going to go, let's see, this one goes, come on. Got to put these frames together, otherwise it'll, put that tree there and then take that off, come up here, turn this on, paste again, and then move it kind of maybe over here. And then we'll merge that down, turn them all on again. Now do the duplicates. And let's see what happens. There we go. Put a little background in there. There's a whole bunch of different things you can do with that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, could you hear that? I didn't know if that's playing through my speakers or not.
I didn't hear it.
Oh, dang it. I had some great music going and nobody could hear it. Hold on.
You have to be, depending on the screen size in Procreate, depends on how many layers you're allowed to get. So the larger the pixel dimensions in the larger the canvas, the less layers you get to work with.
Okay,
because basically it's got kind of a memory maximum.
Yeah, memory maximum. So, oh man, we got to turn that back on again. Hang on.
We're not going to be able to put this on YouTube now, but oh well.
Here we go. Well, shut it down quickly then.
Everybody now. There you go.
What else can we talk about? And that's pretty much it. I mean, we could play around here with different things. Any questions on that at all? Let's see. We've got riding a bike. Here's one we haven't done. This is an interesting.
We've talked about how we're, you know, this kind of empowers the non-drawers amongst us to carry this kind of thing out when we need it. Dana has a question in the chat there. Do you think there's still lots of learning in fundamental drawing techniques when you're tracing over a pre-designed character, like feeling what correct proportions are?
Oh, yes.
Like feeling what correct proportions are supposed to feel like when your pen connects to the paper.
Well, yeah. That's a great question. So here's an example. We're going to do this bike character here. So typically what I'll do is I'll actually start with a pencil. So if we want to kind of do what, if I were going to do this, let me find a good pencil here. I would start sketching, right? How I want this to look. So this comes around this way. Maybe this character has, you know, some shorts on. So I'll put a little cuff on the shorts here. Maybe he's a camper, so maybe one of the little cargo box things here. He's out like that. So that's the cargo. Then we got, the belt line right there. This comes up. Maybe it was a backpack on its back. Then we come down here. Now these don't really look like they're the right hands. So I got to, bring some handlebars out here like this. So they're really, so he's gripping the handlebars, kind of come up, then what, has he got a shirt on like this? And then when it comes to legs, you got your, the calves and stuff like that. So this is the end. So a calf, actually, you got the calf muscle kind of curves out that way. And then you got the kneecap. You can put a little muscle line there. And this because this leg is up, this muscle is tight. So that's a little tighter curve right there. So, as you're going through this, anatomy is a whole nother discipline.
Mm-hmm. Right? Kevin, we got switched back to the original pose app in terms of what you're displaying there.
Oh, my goodness. Thank you. Well, I'm just, heads down over here.
No worries. but I mean, the goal of this is to help us non-artistic folks get something that we can use, because, eventually the stock photos run out and or the stock characters don't match what you need, and being able to, make things that are customized without also investing years of drawing lessons, but even just, hours and hours of time coming up with something, even just using for storyboard. If you're, working with another, with an agency or something that's going to give you more finished, polished things, but at least you can start helping them understand the expression that you want or the physical posing, etc. Very cool.
Yeah. Well, it's especially if you're prototyping and you just want to get a concept out, and then you don't have to be the artist. You could have somebody else, the graphic artist, somebody else that's on the team, or somebody you're going to hire out and say, you're just doing this as a way to get manage the expectations of, here's the character that we're going to try to use here for this, right? So you can, we got to give this dude a helmet. Let's give him a bike helmet. Oh, and he's got one of those.
Let's give him a biking helmet.
Yeah, he's got one of those really cool mohawk things on top of his bike helmet.
Nice. There you go.
He's a bike courier, right?
There you go, bike courier.
I love the idea of the stick figure. That had not crossed my mind when you said that. That opened up all sorts of possibilities for me. I think that's my takeaway for this. Now I actually feel like I might buy it, because you make stick figures feel like, oh yeah, those are so easy to do. But again, it's the proportions, and to be able to have a tool like this to be able to help you make the pose first, and then draw the stick figure lines through the center of those positions to get it just right, is super helpful.
I'd have to play around. I'm not sure I'm doing the frame. I probably should have drawn the frame of this bike first, but.
Yeah. Well, and I remember in your earlier lessons that you were giving us with drawing, and like some folks have already mentioned in the chat and whatnot, when we're being taught how to do it, we kind of draw those circle for the body and then another circle for the head, and we have to kind of do all that kind of stuff ourselves. So an app like this gets us further along. All those little starting circles are already done, and you just position them, and then you're good to go.
Right.
So super cool.
Yeah. Well, you know, going back to your stick figure, and you're absolutely right. I hadn't thought about that because, you know, usually when I'm, my brain is at a different place, right? So when I'm thinking of poses, I'm thinking of actually fully drawn out characters. So from a stick figure perspective, let's grab one. Holding.
Yeah, think how fast you can do a walking pose or a running or a jumping if you're just doing a stick figure, right? You
can
just really crank out some really interesting animations.
So like this one, if you're just, and again, it's just prototyping, right? So if you just need to kind of demonstrate, right? So we just, you know, give it a head, which is a circle, right? Let's go back to our fundamentals. And if this helps, here's another tip. If this helps, put dots at the joints.
Okay.
Right. So you know where the hips and the knees and everything are at. So if this helps you kind of map out where you're, so then just, it's like connect the dot, right? So I need to go to this dot, and then I go to this dot, and then go to this dot, and then we got the ankle here and the ankle here, and then connect that dot. There's my foot. There's my other foot. Bring this dot down, bring this dot over, and then connect the dots. And then, you know, pushing something. So maybe there's...
Chat room, you're on fire today. Thank you.
You know, they're pushing a big box of some kind, right?
Mm-hmm. Or just an invisible box, because it's the course on mime.
Fragile.
I love it.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So get rid of your guide, and there you go. You've got a concept.
Go.
You've got a concept that you can communicate really quickly. And it took us 15
perfect
seconds.
For storyboarding, or even just early drafting ideas, et cetera, as you're trying to get things going. Yep, for sure. Yep. Speaking of getting things going, we probably, we've hit the point where we need to maybe run the, oh, there it is. There's the theme music. Kevin, this is very cool. And something that I think a lot of folks can obviously jump into, you know, making practical use in a hurry of this kind of stuff. So thanks so much for bringing it to us.
Yeah. All good stuff.
Indeed.
Yeah,
and where
Dana,
can people
excellent.
Find you?
Huh? Oh.
Where can people find you, man?
Somewhere in the Mid-South in a frog room.
In a frog room?
Front room over garage.
Oh, interesting.
Ever heard of that one?
No.
I have not. That's, you know, you learn something new every day here, folks, on Idiotic every Wednesday morning.
Nice. Kevin's contact details are in there. If anybody wants to connect with him on the socials or the other places, there you go, gang. As always, Kevin, thanks so much for joining us. Looking forward to what we're going to do next time we have you back, and where we're going to take all of this.
Never know what we'll discover between now and then.
Exactly.
And let's not forget Idiotic.
Hey, Mike.
Now has a community group on LinkedIn. Everybody get on over to LinkedIn and hang out with us, and we can talk more about this stuff. We'll share some links over there, and keep an eye out for the blog post from this episode. We'll add some links and some fun stuff there.
Stick figures rule.
Mm-hmm. Awesome, gang. Let's dance on out. Happy Wednesday,
all right,
everybody.
Let's do it. We're out of here. Thanks, Kevin.